The Situation Room with Wolf Blitzer, weekday afternoons at 5 Eastern on CNN.
On its face, President Obama's budget is a disappointment. If you look out over 10 years, as Matt Miller points out in the blog today, the federal government will be spending some $45 trillion over the next 10 years. This only knocks 1% off the spending over 10 years, hardly a lot. The annual deficit, the annual interest payments on the debt will go up, will quadruple over the next 10 years. The national debt will go up over $7 trillion. And that, Jessica, is unoptimistic assumptions. It's worth remembering that we just learned from the White House today that the deficit this year is going to be $1.6 trillion. Do you know that's 80% more than they were forecasting just 2 years ago? 80% growth in the deficit for this year and a 90% growth for 2012 over what they forecast 2 years ago. So we're on a bad trajectory here, and I'm afraid the president's budget doesn't solve it. Now, in his defense, I must say they've got a terrible political situation on their hands, and I understand the game they're playing. Neither they nor the Republicans want to be bold because they think it'll cripple them in the 2012 elections. But at some point, somebody in Washington's got to be saying, I want to go first. Let's get the negotiations going. Let's get serious, because Alan Simpson is fundamentally right. Unless you deal with Medicare, Medicaid, Social Security, and defense, you're not going to get there in terms of trimming this and getting this budget, getting the nation's finances under control.
Well, privately, David, White House administration official would acknowledge that we do need to have an adult conversation. So are they abdicating their responsibility to lead right now on this issue?
Look, there's a powerful argument on the side of where is the leadership, because we are accustomed to presidents now putting the budget out there and then Congress responding. In this case, the president, the White House is once again saying, Congress, you take the lead and I'll come along and help, you know, and help guide the discussions. That's not the leadership we customarily look to, but again, I want to be sympathetic in one sense, because President Obama does face very unusual circumstances. He's inherited these large deficits, and he's not getting the kind of cooperation from the Republican side that would make negotiations promising. So he's trying to warm up negotiations a little later. Later in the year, maybe it will happen. I'm skeptical we'll get there. I think the greater likelihood is, because neither side is prepared to lead right now in a bold way, that the likelihood is we're going to once again kick the can down the road. This, we will not deal with the seriousness of those big four items you talked about, and Senator Simpson talked about, until after the 2012 elections, and that imperils the country.